Hello everyone. I will speak today about how to become an expert in software testing. So let's explore what we have. So we'll speak about why is this important? Why becoming or being an expert in software testing is important for you as a tester. Then we will try to have kind of build this formula for expertise and to think about what is software testing anyway, what is the real definition or the true definition of software testing. Then we will come to the main variable in the equation of expertise regarding software testing. So why is it important to become an expert in software testing? Basically, yes, a lot of people are thinking of income. Once you are expert in your field, you will be much better. That you will be able to serve your clients and your manager. You will have this feeling of self-worth because you are serving in an amazing way, and you will have fun with your day-to-day activities and duties. You will have this amazing reputation, people connecting with you, asking you questions, and giving you an idea about their challenges, other experts communicating with you and telling you your stories. I mean, you may have your own reasons for considering expertise in software testing, but can we have this formula to become an expert in software testing? So an expert may be a person who is knowledgeable about or skillful in a particular area. Can we consider expertise to be directly related to the number of years of experience? Is it related to certifications? Is it about tools? A lot of them, just to give an idea that I'm an expert, I know software testing. For me, I've learned from Jane Weinberg a different definition of expertise, like he's defining an expert as someone who is qualified to help. So what is expertise anyway? Expertise is about having this hands-on experience, knowing things because you're practicing them. You have been through a lot of challenges, you have tried to test applications, you have failed, you have reported a lot of bugs, you have investigated the bugs that you have found and reported this to developers, back and forth, a lot of things, a lot of stories. You have contributed to the field, to the craft. You have taught a lot of things to other people. And you have this amazing mentor who is always on your shoulders. But what about software testing? Can we know more about software testing regarding, for example, from job descriptions? For example, job descriptions are asking us to ensure quality, to have the competency, the skill to ensure quality. So can automation, Selenium, and all the tools mentioned in the theory of the field teach us about the craft? I mean, there is different school of thoughts regarding software testing. There is different communities. I advise you to try to explore them. I advise you to read a lot and to see what resonates most with you. For me, I see testing as a social skill. As I see a tester in the center of the testing craft, because he's the one who will determine the quality of testing. He's the one who will be blamed if he misses bugs, and he will be praised if he will help us gain more knowledge about the product. But let's see, ask another question. Which type of testers are you? Are you, for example, someone who is interested in people, a social tester? Are you more interested in getting things done, so you are more as a manager? Are you, for example, interested in coding, so more as a technical? So for me, the main variable in the equation isn't certification, isn't teachers, your mentors or your teacher, even though they are interesting, they are very important, but they aren't the main factor in the whole issue. Isn't about the prizes that you get. It isn't about the courses that you learn, even though all of those are important. Actually, your self-worth starts when you get this decision, when you make this decision to become an expert on your field. When you, the main factor is about you. It's about your daily work on improving yourself. And the other point is that once you start teaching software testing, you start teaching every single thing that you learn from this craft. You will learn how to deal with fear. So teaching is actually a secret formula in order to deal with this fear and to start every day improving your expertise and raising your level of expertise. It's okay to look like an idiot. It's okay to look ignorant. You are at the center of everything. And please, please dream big. Try to build this dream 100 list of testers, experts that you really want to enter into their circles, to become their students, to get their attention, and will change totally your journey in testing. So being an expert actually pays off on a psychological level, on a sociological level, on a professional level, on a financial level. Try to bring your own formula. I've given you mine for today. Tomorrow I'll have a better one. Try to build your own formula, your own list of steps, and keep improving it over time. And remember, you will not gain expertise reading books and having courses. You will become an expert by getting your hands dirty. The more you do, the more you test, the more you contribute, the more you review others' work, the more you learn. And try to make a definition for yourself. Always remember that you are at the center of your journey, of your professionalism in software testing. And if you want to speak more about this, please feel free to connect with me and to ask questions and to have this half an hour discussion that will be worth it for you and me. Thank you very much.